नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माय नेम इज चेवेंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक दैट इज एनर्जी फ्लो एंड इकोलॉजिकल पिरामिड्स, एंड द सब्जेक्ट नेम इज इकोलॉजी एंड इवोल्यूशन। सो लेट स्टार्ट। लेस देन 50% ऑफ द इंसिडेंट सोलर रेडिएशन इज फोटोसिंथेटिकली एक्टिव रेडिएशन। सो प्लांट्स कैप्चर ओनली 2 to 10% ऑफ द पीएआर, दैट इज द फोटोसिंथेटिकली एक्टिव रेडिएशन। All organisms are directly or indirectly dependent on for food on producers. So there is a unidirectional flow of energy from sun to producers and then to consumers. This obeys the first law of thermodynamics. So ecosystem need to a constant supply of energy to synthesize the required molecules of to counteract the universal tendency towards increasing disorderliness. This obeys the second law of the thermodynamics. So grazing food chain, the food chain which begins with the producers is called grazing food chain. So a simple grazing chain is depicted here. The grasses eaten by the goat and eaten by the man. So the producer, grasses are the producer, then goat is primary consumer and the man is the secondary consumer here. So detritus food chain is the food chain which begins with dead organic matter is called the detritus food chain. So GFC is the major conduit for energy flow in the aquatic ecosystem. On the other hand, the DFC is the major conduit for energy flow in the terrestrial ecosystem. So some of the organisms of DFC are prey to the GFC animals in a natural ecosystem. Some animals are omnivores. So what is the topical levels? The specific place which an organism occupies in the food chain is called the topical level of the organism. So producers belong to the first tropic level, herbivores belong to the second tropical level, and carnivores belong to the third tropic level. So standing crop, what is standing crop? Each tropic level has a certain mass of living material at a particular time. This amount of mass of living material is called the standing crop. And the standing crop is measured in terms of mass of living organism, that is biomass, or the number in the unit area. The biomass of a species is expressed in terms of fresh or dry weight, and measured in terms of dry weight is more accurate. So what is ecological pyramids? So it is a graphical representation of relationship between organism that varies tropic at various tropic levels in a food chain. So the basis of ecological pyramid is biomass, energy, and number. Just as the name suggests, ecological pyramid are in the shape of the pyramid. The concept was first introduced by the Charles Elton, the pioneer British ecologist. So the bottom of the ecological pyramid is the broadest as and is occupied by the producers. They form the first tropic level, just as in the food chain in the ecological pyramid. Also, the primary consumers occupy the next level, and this is because primary consumers consume producers. Similarly, secondary consumers occupy the third level, and then the tertiary consumers occupy the next level, and so on. The types of ecological pyramids, they depends on the factors that we use to represent an ecological pyramid. There are three types of the ecological pyramids: ecological pyramid of numbers. So here the important factor is the number of organisms in each tropic level. As we go up the levels of pyramid, the number of organisms decrease. The producers from the largest number and hence are at the bottom of the pyramid. Then the ecological pyramid of energy. The energy pyramid is an upright pyramid that represents the flow of energy from the producer to the final consumer. The ecological pyramid of biomass. This pyramid represents the amount of biomass of the organism present at each tropic level. So biomass is nothing but the weight of the organism. So in general, all ecological pyramids are upright except in certain cases. For example, in a detritus food chain, the pyramid of number is not upright. This is because many organisms feed on one dead plant or animal. The pyramid of biomass is an ocean. Is also inverted. This is because the biomass of producers in an ocean is less. But a point of note is that the energy pyramid is always upright, as the flow of energy is unidirectional. So hope you are satisfied with this little session. If you have any query, please write in the comment box. I will resolve your query. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. थैंक यू।